graphics, and we did spend a considerable amount of time in the last 2 years doing an assessment of all the buildings. Hired A&E architects out of Bozeman to do a thorough assessment of all four of our buildings and give us some recommendations on the cost and benefit of improving or replacing. We spent about 9 months with the community group, representatives from a broad range of the community, just looking through that assessment. And if you want the assessment, there's a copy of the school. It's about 400 pages, I think, the total assessment. So that group spent a tremendous amount of time trying to digest all that information and then coming forward with the bond request that we put forth last spring. I think at this point, the needs have not gone away. From my perspective, I think Ross spoke well to the age of our schools. We have a community that's young. We have a lot of young children here tonight. We have a lot of young families in our community. My kids all went to school here. All of them completed all 15 years of school here. I think they all received an excellent education here. But Jefferson, in the late 1980s, when my first daughter started, is a far different school now. The needs of kids are far different. The way education is provided is far different. So I don't know that I think that new school is off the table. I think it requires a community conversation. What do we want to do for the community? What do we want to do for the kids in our community? What kind of facilities do we want them to be educated in? Do we want them to have the advantages that many of us had going to school, that many of our kids had? Or are we happy to continue to use the buildings that are 50 to 75 years old and places older than that? And in some ways limit the ability of our teachers to really teach to their full capacity the learning styles we know are best for kids in this day and age.